Welcome to the ZTV Sports Report.
On this episode, we check out the men's soccer team's road to the MAC title and the NCAA tournament.
Plus, can the football team make it to its second straight bowl game? Our insider Don Wagner gives us his thoughts on what's going on and how far this team can go.
All that and more on the ZTV Sports Report that starts right now. Welcome to the ZTV Sports Report. I'm Daniel Cermak.
And I'm Cameron Justice. The soccer team was back on the field, this time searching for their 12th straight MAC championship.
That's right. Not only were they trying to retain the title, but they also tried to fight their way back to the NCAA tournament.
We have highlights of the Zips games against Grand Canyon and their games in the MAC tournament. Let's check it out.
The University of Akron's men's soccer team faced Grand Canyon on November 2nd at First Energy Stadium Cub Cadet Field. It didn't take long for the Zips to get on the scoreboard, as Nikki DeVera scored to give Akron the lead at the 7:37 mark. Early on, the Zips had complete control of the game, but couldn't capitalize on shots on goal to expand the lead. The Zips missed another opportunity when Azam Kasey just barely misses a well-placed pass through four defenders. Grand Canyon's defense kept them in the game after going down 1-0 early as they negated Akron's goal opportunity. Grand Canyon finally starts to show life offensively when Damian German fails to connect with the ball for a goal shot. Grand Canyon gets four players in the goal box, and Charles Keaton saves the ball just before it goes out of bounds, and Nikki Jackson scores to tie the game at one apiece. Adam Najem delivers a great pass to Jonathan Lewis, but he misses the goal shot and the score was tied at one apiece at the half. Grand Canyon looked much better on offense out of the break as Nikki Jackson's goal shot barely misses the goal. The Lobes had a great chance to take the lead on a free kick, but Ben Lunt denied it. Finally, the Zips were able to connect on a well-placed pass as Robbie Dambrot finds a wide-open Stuart Holthusen behind Grand Canyon's defenders, and he finishes with the goal to give Akron the lead. However, the Lobes responded quickly with the equalizer as Jamie Olvera heads the ball into the net to tie the game at two apiece. The game would go to overtime, and it looked as if Grand Canyon would go on to win as they had multiple chances to score. When it mattered most, the Zips defense stepped up to give them a chance to win the game in overtime. The Zips had a chance to win the game, but Stuart Holthusen's shot was defended by Grand Canyon's goalie, and Jonathan Lewis's rebound shot gets blocked right before it crosses the goal line. The Zips hit Peter on their next scoring chance, as Stuart Holthusen kicks a game-winning goal, and Akron would go on to win 3-2 to improve to 9-5-3 on the season.
The Akron Zips men's soccer team honored their five seniors, Gonzalo Torres, Danilo Rachin, Brad Ruhak, Tyler Sanda, and Adam Najem before their final home regular season match against Western Michigan. The Zips needed a win and needed Bowling Green to either draw or lose to Buffalo in order to win their 12th straight MAC title. Getting things started, Jonathan Lewis and Stuart Holthusen played big roles in the Akron attack, and early in the game it showed, with Lewis finding Manuel Cruggiero, who found Holthusen, whose header is dangerous, but easily saved. Then Lewis takes it into the box and cuts it back and lets the shot go, but it's well wide of the post. Now here, Lewis to Holthusen, who can't quite finish, and Lewis on the rebound, cleared away. Maybe some frustration setting in for Akron, but it wouldn't last long, as Holthusen gives a chance off a Western Michigan turnover, rips a shot, and it ricochets off Kyle Tolliman, and into the back of the net. 1-0 Akron, they are currently in line to win the MAC, with Buffalo and Bowling Green tied. Following the Akron goal, Western Michigan started to look dangerous, as Zach Bach sends it across, and finds Anthony Bowie, who heads it down straight to Jake Roof, who beats Ben Loot but does not beat Shane Golden Wheat as it's cleared out. Now we all know how crazy the past week has been. But maybe the craziest thing happens here as Adam Najem turns it over in his own half and Tommy Clark's shot beats Loot but does not beat the post and it's just wide. Akron will get an important insurance goal here through who else but Jonathan Lewis and Stuart Holthusen, who taps home the rebound from Lewis and tries to celebrate with Alex Rudock, who wasn't too happy about it, or being down 2-0. Najem will make up for his turnover with this insane pass over the top to Holthusen, who just can't find Lewis on the cross. Now listen, Akron has scored some good goals this year, with Tyler Sanders versus Seattle standing out thanks to Adam Najem's absurd pass. But I'm going to go ahead and call this next goal the goal of the year. Jonathan Lewis gets the ball out wide, easily beats the first defender, fights off the second, and then nutmegs the third. And then, I mean, at that point, it's just an easy pass to Zanikase, who's not going to miss that. In the Bowling Green, tying Buffalo, Akron would win their 12th straight MAC regular season title and will host the MAC tournament, where they will have a rematch with the Broncos.
Your Akron Zigs are the 2016 MAC regular season champions.
The men's soccer team took on Western Michigan in the MAC semifinals on November 11th, and Akron started the game off hot after a back and forth in the first 20 minutes of play. Junior Stuart Holthusen nailed a nice goal off the shoulder of freshman Nick Hines and straight into the back of the net, making the score 1-0. Western Michigan worked to get back in the game with a shot from Connor McNulty, but the ball went high and wide. This game had a lot of contact, one of the first resulting in a penalty kick for Akron, which junior Sam Gainford slid into the net, giving the Zips a 2-point lead going into the second half. Sophomore Izana Kase had a close one-on-one shot but just missed. But freshman Marcel Zajac picked it up with Akron's third goal of the game. Kase wasn't one to be slept on though, as he scored off a beautiful pass from freshman Jonathan Lewis, putting the Zips up 4-0, and apparently skyrocketing the tension between the two teams. The contact between the teams kept the game intense, and as the game continued, the tensions began to rise. It seemed as though Western Michigan could not emotionally handle this huge deficit they faced. Western Michigan's Brandon Bai was at the center of the brawling, instigating a fight with senior Adam Najem at first, and then later on with sophomore Shane Wheat after some major contact in the corner. Yellow card after yellow card was being thrown, but Angry Bai just couldn't resist taking it up a notch, and after a nasty takedown, was given a red card and thrown out of the game. Not that it mattered for Western Michigan though, they just couldn't get it together, and the Zips defeated them with the final score of 4-0.
Sunday, the Akron men's soccer team took on Buffalo in the Mid-American Conference Tournament. They started out by firing shots at the goal right away. Here, midfielder Adam Najem crosses the ball right to forward Sam Gainford's feet, just missing the back post with a volley toward the goal. Just after, we get another chance. Nick Hines, who attempts for that far corner goal, but unfortunately misses. Another cross from the right corner was sent through to the middle. Stuart Hathusen just got his foot on it, but had no luck. Frustrations were getting high for the Zips with all these near misses. Nick Hines gets another opportunity and pops one over, sending him back in the game to try again. And try again he did. With just under 14 minutes left in the first half, Hines sends one through to the back of the net, finally putting the score at 1-0 Akron. The second half started off right away. Just under 3 minutes into the half, Nick Hines rolls another one into the Buffalo goal, putting Akron now ahead 2-0. But it didn't last the entire game. Buffalo finally got their breakaway chance around the 27th minute in the second half, putting the score now at 2-1, with Akron still ahead. Later in that half, Hines collides into the Buffalo keeper, forcing Buffalo to switch their goalies out due to an injury. Akron was given quite a few more chances after that, but Buffalo's second string keeper was lucky enough to keep the Zips from scoring again. Not without lack of trying, though. They ended up finishing the game on top with a 2-1 score, making the Akron Zips the MAC tournament champions. The Zips received their rewards with bright eyes and excited hearts, for their hard work had paid off. They celebrate their tournament win, but also look forward to the next game, which will be the first round of the NCAA tournament against Villanova. The next game is on Thursday, November 17th. Tip-off will be at 5 p.m.
How about that, Cammie? Not only are we MAC champions, but we're also headed back to the NCAA tournament.
This team is winning at the right time, and their road to the Cup is about to begin.
Cannot wait. But unfortunately, we will have to wait a little bit to get back to all the action, as it's time to take a break.
But don't go anywhere, as the DTV Sports Report will be right back.
Welcome back to the ZTV Sports Report.
The Akron football team found themselves just one win away from bowl eligibility before taking on a 1-8 Bowling Green on Wednesday.
Let's check out the highlights, and then after, we'll hear from Don about his hot take on the state of the program. Let's check it out.
Akron took on Bowling Green. A win, and they would become bowl eligible. Early on, James Morgan hooks up with receiver Teal Redding to get the Falcons into the red zone. A couple plays later, and running back Fred Coppett bounces off a couple tackles and gets in for six. Trayvon Chapman and the Zips offense looking to respond, and Austin Wolf with a nice catch, getting the Zips inside the red zone. But Akron would settle for a field goal, making the score 7-3 Bowling Green. Next Falcons possession, running back Donovan Wilson is out, and he, rumbling down the sideline, gets inside the 30 to about the 27. A couple plays later, and running back Fred Coppett finds his way into the end zone once again for his second score of the day. But Akron has a pretty good running back of their own. His name is Van Edwards. Here, he weaves his way through traffic, gets inside the Falcons territory, and then on another play, he bounces it to the outside. Oh, great block, and Van will take it inside the 5-yard line. Trayvon Chapman takes the direct snap and goes right into the end zone. Getting close to the end of the first half, and Trayvon Chapman trying to make something happen, and he is hit hard from behind. The ball comes loose. Bowling Green says they have it, but more importantly, the referees, they also say that they have it. A direct snap to Ronnie Moore, and he swan dives into the end zone, giving Bowling Green a 21-10 lead. Second half, in comes receiver Tyrell Goodman to play quarterback for the Zips, and he shows off his arm, dropping the dime to JoJo Natson all the way to the 1-yard line. Direct snap to Van the Man Edwards, and he pushes the pile just enough to get in for six. Fourth quarter, and Akron's down 8. Goodman drops back and launches a bomb, and Jerome Lane Jr. can get off me, little dude, and he gets into the end zone. Now Akron would have to score a 2-point conversion to tie. Goodman, once again, he finds Jerome Lane and send it in, Jerome. Oh, he is strong. You the daddy's son. But Akron just couldn't stop the run, and they would drop this one 38-28.
Welcome to the one, the only, the Don Take.
The Don is back in studio. That's right. The best segment produced this side of the Mississippi.
It's true. We're going to talk about the football team's recent struggles and getting right into it. Do you think the football team's going to make a bowl game?
No, not at all. You know the joke, oh, what goes in a bowl and cereal, and it's not going to be Akron this time. So, honestly, they have injuries, and they have question marks on defense. And, honestly, if you lose to the teams that two teams that only have one win, and the last one at home, a Bowling Green team, they should have won that game. And you lose, it just shows you don't have composure. And I just, nope, not going to happen. Not this year. Maybe next year.
So, Don, what do you think the issues are with the team then?
For starters, like I said, injuries for sure. You lose your starting quarterback, then you lose your second string quarterback. He was knocked out of the Bowling Green game. And that's tough to win games like that. And then more on-field issues is the rush defense. The rush defense is if you want to beat the Akron Zips, you just hand the ball off as much as you possibly can. They've had big games. Western Michigan, they had a big game against us on the ground. Appalachian State, almost 300 yards. It's kind of embarrassing. So they have to get that straightened out.
So what do you have to? What do they have to do to win against OU?
They need to walk down a beach. They need to look down on the ground. They need to see something shiny. They need to pick it up, and it's a lamp. They need to rub it. A genie pop out. And they need to wish for injuries, a better rush defense, and not to play OU on the road. It's not reality. Not this time around. Bowling Green did beat us at home. I wasn't expecting that. So we got a chance. It may be small, and all jokes aside, they do have a good offense. They move the football. They're going to have to air it out. They're going to have to hit JoJo Natson. They're going to have to hit Jerome Lane. Van Edwards is going to have to get it going on the ground. If they can do that, they can score. So if they hit big plays, that's the small chance that I see that they can pull it out and win this one.
All right, well, hopefully they can do it. That's all we have for Dante. It's time to take a break, but don't go anywhere because we'll be right back. Welcome back to the ZTV Sports Report.
Well, Cammie, there's still a month to go until winter, but my favorite season has already gotten underway.
Yeah, we know how you love fall, you and your pumpkin spice lattes and Ugg boots.
Halloween town, cuddling. No, basketball season, Cammie.
Oh, yeah.
Basketball
season. You're right.
And we have all the action from the women's team's early season matchups against Walsh and Malone. Let's take a look.
The Akron women's basketball team opened up its season in an exhibition game against Walsh University on Saturday, November 5th. The Zips starting off strong. Alex Ricketts spins off the defender and puts up a nice mid-range jumper. Later in the first quarter, Zips doing what they do best, Megan Sepsik buries not one, but makes it two threes. She finished with 14 points in this one. And then Hannah with a three. Zips go up 24-21 at the end of the first quarter. But the second quarter, Walsh comes out on fire. Alex Hochstetler hits the three. Jalen Graham pitches in with a three. And they just continuously go back and forth. Walsh ends up going on a 13-1 run in the beginning of the second quarter. But the Zips start to come back alive. Hannah Kleiben and Megan Sefcik both drain the three. And then to finish off the second quarter, Kleiben on the drive starts to fall, but makes a beautiful pass to Haley Renhall for the layup. Second half, more from Hannah, just doing her thing. Hits another three. Hannah would finish this game with 18 points. And then the beautiful ball work on display from the Zips. Edmonds to Ricketts, who finds Ali Ball, who drains a three. And then Hannah and Haley connecting again on the backdoor pass. Zips are starting to run away with this one. Ricketts with an easy layup. And the ball movement continues to thrive for the Zips. Kleiben finds Greta Burry. And then Harmon to Reinhold again. And the Zips end up taking this one 81-7.
The Akron Zips women's basketball team hosts the Malone Pioneers here at the Jar. The Zips win the tip-off and strike early as Greta Burry puts the nice post moves on the Malone defender to score. But Malone will show that they came to play as number 4, Baylen Herman with some post moves of her own, then coming right back with a mid-range shot. Her three-pointer wouldn't fall, but then here comes Naomi Grandison with the rebound and the putback. Here's Brittany Gordon with a nice driving finish, then here's Shayna Edmonds with a nice mid-range shot, and then a drive from Hannah Kleiben. There's Baylen Derman with another basket. She would lead her team with 20 points and 13 rebounds, 12 of which came in the first half. Here's Greta Burry with the mean block saying, "Get that out of here." At the half, the score is the Zips 23, the Pioneers 26. To start off the second half, the Zips go coast to coast to Ali Ball, who gets a layup and one. Ball looking like LeBron James, finishing these layups after the foul. She would end the game with 11 points, all of which came in the second half. Malone's Hannah McHugh would come right back with an and one of her own and making the free throw. She ended the game with 13 points. Late in the game, the Zips showed who was the better team when they went on a run. Here's Megan Sefcik with a dagger to close the game out for the victory. Hannah Kleiben would be the high scorer for the Zips, scoring 20 points. The final score of the game, the Zips 63, the Pioneers 52.
The women's team is off to a baller start this season.
Definitely. And after the struggles of men's soccer and football, I cannot wait for basketball teams to rack up some dubs.
Zips Nation to Dubs Nation.
Let's not take it that far.
Okay, fair, fair. We won't take it that far.
But we will have to take a break. A 3-week break. But the next time you see a ZTV Sports Report, we'll be live from Colby Hall.
But until then, you can follow us on social media at ZTV Sports on Twitter and Instagram, and the ZTV Sports Report on YouTube and Facebook.
That's all we have for this week. We'll see you next time on the ZTV Sports Report, your home for everything Akron Zips Athletics.
Steph Curry, 3-point contest, who you got?
Steph Curry!
Oh, come on. Soccer or Adam Najram playing basketball?
I would say... Yeah, soccer.
Yeah, soccer.
Rivalry.
You're Steph Curry, who's a 3-point contest?
Steph Curry today, me tomorrow.
Yeah, tomorrow, there you go. Fair enough.